It's now 6:30, and we call to order the Select Board meeting of Monday, March 5th. First on the agenda is the approval of minutes. We have two sets of regular meeting on last Monday, and then the special meeting after the public hearing on the 20th. Any comments, questions on the minutes?
No.
By consensus, then they are approved. Community input. Okay, department heads, I see one. Caroline.
Thank you, if you don't mind. Yes.
Welcome.
Yeah.
Move that we go into non-public session for the purpose of hearing welfare petitions.
Second.
Roll call. Michael?
Yes.
Jody?
Yes.
Suzanne, yes.
We don't need our guests. For welfare case 2018-002, Select Board is recommending up to $1,500 in rental assistance.
Second.
Any discussions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
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 And Corey, for purposes of minute taking, Jody had the motion to exit non-public, seconded by Michael. And I did a roll call, we all said yes. Thank you. All right, seeing no other department head, we will go on to town administration. Town warrant, town meeting, those kinds of things. Childcare, was there anything more to add? I think Caroline wanted to know what we were offering.
What did we offer on?
So apparently, it's $18 for people over 18, and I guess anyone else, $15? Is that?
Yeah, I guess Caroline sent an email today saying her daughter can't do it.
That's correct.
Okay.
So now we're back to one again? Oh, she was the second, okay.
Yeah.
You had, did you say somebody was?
They were interested, they haven't come down to town hall, so. And a lot of the camper kids in camp aren't around, they're all at college.
Okay. So this is something that is not on anyone's printed agenda, and that is to assign speakers for the warrants. We can do it. This, we can do it tonight, or we can wait till next Monday. We still have them, so. Before we get ready, we can just kind of do it.
We can start working on it. Do we have a copy of the, we don't have a printed copy of the warrant.
No, let's ask Caroline to print. We'll go on to something else, and I'll ask Caroline.
Table for now.
Yes, we'll table.
Table the non-existent.
Will our books be here by this week?
What's that?
Will our books be here by this week?
I don't know.
Is that?
Is that the rubber box?
Zone planning.
Bell machine, yep.
Yeah, because she's going to do it tomorrow.
I haven't seen it before. I didn't know what it was.
Oh.
I guess I had noticed it when I bought it the last time.
All right, we'll go on and she'll.
We'll have 2 weeks to think about it.
Management response, I haven't yet drafted anything, but thank you for your comments from last week. And New Year, that's kind of the year just so we can be mindful of, you know, appointing committee chairs and those other kinds of things that we will have to do as soon as town meeting is over.
Yeah, Rick wanted to know, if you're just appointing, or they're just going to, on the floor, one of the chairs.
I'm sorry.
Rick, they're just going to appoint, or from the floor, who are the chairs, and then you guys will appoint who's on the committee that following Monday.
I guess I'm still, I'm confused. Nothing goes on at town meeting for the rec committee.
Parks and Rec.
That's park, that park, it's Parks and Recs, I don't even know.
Well, I'm saying that, I think that's more than confusing.
That's where it happens, like someone's like, Dee's going to be chair, and everybody seconds, and then.
No, we don't do chairs at town meeting. And Parks and Rec is different from the rec committee. So it remains unclear to me exactly what the Parks and Recs is. We only had two people on it last year, and they don't report to us, and we don't see them. And it could be three. I know you've done some looking in the town meeting, but the rec committee is a committee that we've appointed here, which is not that Parks and Rec, it's our.
Okay, but if you look back at last year's minutes, from the floor, they reappointed Dee and Kelly. Just saying.
The book says Tia Pass and somebody else.
Right, but that was the year before. That book was from the year before that.
What do you?
And then in the middle of the season, 2000, whatever, I lost track. They resigned, and then we appointed Dee and Kelly in 2016. Because that's the 2000, no, 2015, that's the 2017 book. So. All right, then I won't worry about it till the Monday after, and they'll give you a list.
Yes, here, Parks and Rec aside, Parks and Recs aside.
Yes.
As far as I'm concerned, the rec committee is a committee of the board, just like, you know, the stormwater committee and the like. So we would appoint members, and those members, you know, elect the chair. So, and the members that we appoint are essentially, I mean, you know, essentially we're grateful for anybody who steps forward to serve. So, you know, I did ask people back in January if they wanted to stay on, if they wanted to, if they know vacancies, if they wanted to appoint, if they wanted us to appoint anybody. So I've got, you know, lists that are sort of been ongoing, I haven't looked at them lately, but.
So warrant article number four, the other town offices.
Yes.
The ones that.
That was like 2016.
Annual report, we elect the mayors of wood and lumber, fence viewer, tree warden, and then parks and recreation. I don't recall, perhaps they both stepped down, Tia and Paul, and they were replaced by two other people.
Yes.
And I thought that Celia Leopold was one of them as well, but at the town meeting, maybe not, so.
She was the one doing the appointment.
But that was just for.
Parks and Rec.
Is different than the recreation.
It is. The Parks and Rec, my understanding from Ed years back, are the people who tell us if there's something that needs to be taken care of in our little parks. We don't have many of them, you know, like Morton Park and Bicentennial Park, and that's kind of what the Parks and Rec folks are supposed to do.
So we never created that as a commission.
It's not a commission.
So we never, it's nothing.
It's kind of, it's like the others that are in there, except that we need three people, theoretically. So, you know, my feeling is if no one from, what normally happens, I don't know that this particular set would be any different. If no one chooses to run, the board could just appoint. So after town meeting, if no one chose to nominate, no one chose to run, the board would just appoint. And my recommendation, and I don't know if the board is amenable to that, but I would like to review all those three or four positions and see what are the statutes associated with them. And if it's possible for us to dissolve that as a position, that maybe it's worthwhile to do so. They're mostly, you know, they all had a purpose in being at some point. They don't seem to be active within the town. They're, you know, sometimes we appoint people as an honorary kind of a thing. Mm-hmm. But it serves no particular practical purpose other than to connect us back to, you know, colonial times. So, I mean, something the board can, you know, I'd like to see the board look at more seriously. So anyway, I think, I don't know if Charlie said, does he want us to have some names for him, some possible names for those things? Would somebody like to make some suggestions?
You got Article 5 operating budget.
No, did you want to make some suggestions for who should be nominated for those other towns?
Oh, the other positions.
Yes.
I The surveyors of wood lumber, the three of them can still do it if they do.
Okay, so who are they again?
Ed Charpentier.
Yep.
Ralph Phipps. Mark Kuchen.
Okay.
I think we may need a new fence viewer. Paul Janus passed away, or one of his brothers?
No, I think it was a brother.
George.
I don't know.
It wasn't him? Well, then we should reappoint him.
Paul.
He's on with a nice long and wrong.
Paul Janus.
On his hand. What's one?
Ed Charpentier, it's true, wood. Let me get the park done up here.
Okay. All right, shall we go on to the... So, operating budget, I would like to speak to this one. I have no objection to speaking to any of them, but I'm happy to, it's nice to hear some other voices. So service truck for the Rollinsford Highway Department.
Did you want a picture to go on a slideshow for that? So people understand what it is.
The truck?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you know, I was just going to, really, I thought we would just do the warrants up on the projection. I wasn't gonna do any folderol for anything else, but it's a...
Just so they understand that it's just not a truck.
What, well, so what would we show them?
A picture of the truck.
Do we have a, I don't know where that's specific, were we that specific?
Yeah, it's a utility truck.
Well, it becomes a utility truck because there's a utility box on it, I think, is the... We could ask George.
So it looks something like that.
Yeah, with a utility, it's the utility box there,
so,
right?
Yeah, it's 4x4 and the boxes, so people don't think it's like a pickup truck or something.
Is it, George was talking about, did he say Ford, is that actually the right model you want to...
250, what he said. Jody, do you want to do Article 6?
Sure.
I'll be happy to do Article 7.
Yeah, okay, yes.
I'll find something that he likes and...
Yeah, just, yeah. Great, thank you.
I just think it'll help visualize.
We can also have it just in the back, you know, for people to look at.
Sure.
You know, on the table. All right, so Jody, thank you.
I'll be happy to do Article 7.
Okay. Police cruiser. Be happy to do that, that's quick. I would love to do the capital improvement reserve fund too.
Would you?
Okay.
Just gonna volunteer, but it's all yours.
Culvert, repair replacement. Conservation land trust capital reserve fund. I'll take it on if there are no takers. Land surveys and related expenses. I'm happy to take it on.
Make Charlie do it.
Pardon?
Make Charlie do it.
Land surveys? Sharp, Charlie?
No, I'm just being surprised.
Housing standards?
I must do that.
Yes, okay. Road resurfacing, I would like to do that. Change road name.
So, just so we're clear though, you'll do the select board response to petitioners?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Are you doing the land service as well? I'm sorry, Wallace, I didn't write down your name.
Yes.
Okay.
I didn't hear hue and cry, so.
Okay, well.
I'm just filling the voids. Change road name. All right, good. Jody, you're on.
This way you can have a sip of water.
Mike, the historical committee.
Yeah, I'm happy.
Okay. Former committee to adopt town manager, we did not recommend, you know, we had grand neutral on that, so.
That's petitioner.
That's petitioner.
Yeah.
Authority to sell surplus equipment and vehicles. I mean, I'll do that, that's just standard. All right, I think we're good. Everybody has their marching orders?
You're doing 18, you said?
Yeah. unless you would like to. It's quick, it's not.
Yeah, no.
All right, so I was about to talk about 4B. So I got a phone call, I just happened to be here on Friday, and it was specifically for me, so I was always surprised. It was the State Department of Labor, and the petition by a former road agent, Jeff Saging, has been canceled. He withdrew.
He withdrew?
He withdrew. Now, what they said was that he can always come back and reinstate his claim.
Yep.
I should have asked, and I was just surprised by the whole conversation, I should have asked, was there a statute of limitation?
I was going to ask that question.
Right, but I doubt that it would happen, but they did say he could.
So you're off the hook, thank you for volunteering.
I was going to ask you, because it's supposed to snow, I wasn't sure it was going to snow.
Oh, right.
It's supposed to start Thursday, really.
That's right, Wednesday, yeah, another nor'easter. Well, it's been canceled.
All right.
So, beehives at the garden club?
Yes.
Did anybody, again, the garden club is expressing a desire, they haven't, you know, they're not there yet either, but they're expressing a desire to seriously explore working with a beekeeper to install a beehive at the gardens just to the right of the stage.
So it's way in the back corner over there?
If you're walking in, you know where the stage is?
I do, yes.
Okay, so it would be just to the right of that. There's a clearing, continues to be
clearing. Yeah, but it's like far away from where the trailhead is, where the kids are.
It's, yes, it's directly opposed from the trailhead.
Less concerned with that then. I mean, there's already bees in the garden anyway, right? So
there are bees in the garden. I mean, there will be signage. And also like fencing, so there'll be a physical.
So the kids can't get near it.
Yeah, you don't want.
Or anywhere,
you know,
really.
It's a public space, right?
Right?
So you want to let people know.
Yeah.
Could vandalism happen? Yes, obviously.
Sure.
I think that the community garden in Durham, you know, Wagon Hill, they keep bees there.
Have you had? I haven't even heard of any vandalism down there. Has there been any?
So the latest I heard is that there was a motorized vehicle, like maybe a four wheeler or something,
yeah,
on the trail. And so,
but people don't go and like tear up your beds or anything. I mean,
we haven't had that kind of. No, it's been four wheelers going down the trail. So we republished the thing. This is no motorized traffic.
Yeah.
You know, some people have filched vegetables from other people's beds. You know, and I don't mean they're gardeners doing it to gardeners, but some people have lost some things.
Right.
But has it been rampant? No, it's been, you know, it's a wonder, you know, it's a nice feeling.
Yeah.
And I also know that we've heard from two or three people who said that when they moved, it was one of the questions they asked when they moved to town, is there a community garden? Not that they were necessarily community gardeners, one of them was, but somehow it connoted to them something that was attractive in a town. So. All right, so I will let the Garden Club board know that we don't have any objection. They may, I'll come back to you if we decide to do it, but.
As long as it's clearly in the side, I mean, it's.
Well, the rec committee just won't go.
Fenced
they
off.
They decided they're not just going to go. So,
well, that was the other thing we were waiting on, yeah. So they won't go.
They just won't go.
You know, the beekeeper would probably be more than willing to have, like, an information session. I mean, that's kind of what the kindergarten teacher, I mean, Becky's delighted to have, you know, the thought of the beekeeper there.
Yeah, but we don't have the manpower to, you have 90, could have up to 90 children divided it out. Even if you take a small group, you have 7 and 8 year olds with no nurse, no nothing. It's something that my daughter is deathly afraid she had stung when she was little, whether it's a bumblebee or not. My son may find a stick and poke through the fence. So we all just thought it was best. Just we'll find another walking path.
Well, let you know. I mean, you know, they may not come to pass.
Yeah.
It's possible the hive isn't successful. I mean, there are lots of things can happen,
right,
too, right?
Right.
So But it's a nice,
Yeah, Brittany didn't want that on her shoulders.
Who?
Brittany didn't want that on her shoulders. She's our accountant, she's our director.
Exactly, she's the director, no problem. You know, it's unfortunate, but, you know, after a while, you know, maybe things will change, you know, people's positions may change. I mean, if, you know, stories may come out, you know, the school may go and have a great time, I mean, who knows, you know, things could happen or not, so. Okay, I will report that back to the garden clerk. Tabling Oak Street boundary, there's nothing to say there. Policies and procedures, we need to get back to at some point for welfare. Oh, Mark, sorry, you walked in and I forgot.
That's fine, continue with your business, I'm fine.
We were this close.
Please.
Good evening.
How are you, chief?
How do you do, Chuck?
Excellent.
Awesome.
Excellent. This is for you, I know I didn't send it, but that's VIN numbers. We don't have a serial number off the engine. If that's something that they wish to find before it gets cut in little baby pieces, they can do that on Wednesday.
Yeah, that's good. So E3 is which one? The new?
E3 is the one that's leaving.
Okay, that's the old, E2 is the new. Alright, so this is the, wow, that's the VIN number, okay, 20 Spartan Boulevard. Great, so I will, what I'm doing is getting templates of the quarterly reports and the annual reports. So I'll do one and then we'll actually print them out for like the 4 quarterly reports and then the 3 annual reports. So this year it's quarterly, and the next year it's annual.
5 years and then?
4, whatever it is.
I understand.
Yeah, yeah. And so I'll just put the VIN number and the model number on that, and then it'll just, so thank you. Thank you. And still 11 o'clock on Wednesday?
That is correct.
Looks like Liz will be there. I was ready to do a form because the terms and conditions said that, you know, we, the board, had to verify or confirm that the deed had happened. And she said she'd come with some kind of form. So we'll talk to her. I'm going to try to be there on Wednesday at 11.
And there'll be some members. I may be there, but if not, Kevin and or a couple other guys.
Okay.
Truck goes tomorrow.
Yeah.
So leave it in the morning at about 8:30, never to come back again.
Yeah.
Goes up here and just like drain all the fluids, prep it for its...
Really? It sounds like embalming.
It's happening to it. Then they got to take it and cut it in a little baby fire truck pieces is all they're going to do, so. Yeah, after, you know, by 11:30 on Wednesday, it's no longer wood.
So it will take only about a half an hour to do this?
Yeah, I think it'll take about time. Well, it might not even take that long, but to meet provisions where they're going to, you know, bore a hole in the engine and cut the frame and all that
take
stuff.
Take pictures. And...
Yeah, because they have a big excavator with a set of shears on it that you just...
So if I want to go there, do I, 236.
Right on 236, if you know, heading up, you go by where the transfer station is,
mm-hmm.
You go down that big hill,
okay.
And just as you start up, it's right there on the left. Berwick, iron, and metal.
Okay.
And if you kept going, you go like where Belanger Paving keeps their trucks, those orange trucks, it's right, you went too far.
Okay.
It's just behind.
All right.
That one dip is right there.
Okay.
Okay.
Yep.
Yep. And setting up there up there tonight, finishing pulling pieces off. You wouldn't even recognize it now. It's stripped of just about everything. So it's going to be hard to go. Mixed feelings.
Yeah, I know.
It's time for it to go.
I know.
Because when you look at the next page, see it sitting there, it's like, okay, it's well worth it. But it has use for somebody. It's just not the way I want to see it go, but it's okay. I have one other piece of business. Purchase order. It's going to be it's number 337. It's to emergency reporting, and it's our annual fee for our software package that we give. And that's, you know, and we've expanded it now, so we put just about every form and report and documentation that we need goes into this, from truck maintenance to training. We're going to be able to put our payroll records on board. All the required records we have to give for the state and national databases and stuff, it all comes through this. So, like I said, it's an annual fee for the fire reporting package. It's $14.
Purchase order number
1337 emergency reporting for annual fee for a fire reporting package for $1,420.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Comes out of training?
It does.
You should probably next year have a new category for information systems.
Yeah, there you go. I could just flop over to that.
That's okay, we'll never be here.
And this goes like out, you keep it, and here's the invoice, and there's also another one that needs to go to Caroline.
Is it separate?
This is the one we.
Yeah, it's just another bill for another.
We expanded it last year, right? Is this the one where we're getting this set of services, now we're getting this set of services again?
If you have something a little bit more than we are able to use for that, so it's basically the point where we need to go and start just pulling up records, it's all right there. Like, we need our truck maintenance records, even though it goes to Dover, Sam Crowley has a link, so we can send it back to us. So if we can pull it all up, not have to go running around.
That's great.
So basically, it's kind of like a catch-all for everything that we really need to track and keep ahead of, so it's a good system for us, and what we need makes it simple for everybody. So, we're happy with that.
All right, anything else?
That's all that I have, so again, I want to just, you know, reiterate that the truck thing is all set and done.
Yeah, no, thank you. It's good, sad. So, you don't have any warrants, right? Just gonna remind you, town meeting. Okay, there's nothing specific.
Nothing for you this year.
All right. Excellent. We probably won't need to call on you then, but you never know, people ask some interesting questions sometimes.
They do, yeah, there's something else that pops up, yeah.
All right, we're good.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay.
This is the more.
Oh, Mark?
Yes.
So, we do have, we'll talk about it later on, or maybe we'll talk about it right, this is the MOA from the city of Dover, so.
Okay.
By Chief Coloruso.
Dispatching?
Yes, so.
And we're gonna loop the money in for our.
Yes.
Section of upgrading for that, okay, yeah, I have a copy of that.
Did you get a copy of that? All right, so we'll, I haven't read this, so we'll take a look at this, I'd like to read it before we do it, and Mike, if you want to take a few minutes, or. All right, so we'll let you know, but I can't imagine there would be a problem here, because it's to our advantage.
Well, the way that they agreed to do it, I thought was pretty good on their part, and again, some of that, I think, was also in the fact that that kind of got dumped on our plate real.
And he said that, he did say that, and I.
They made changes right at the end that they.
Yeah, he said, and he admitted that that was a last, very last minute adjustment, you know, and sometimes this happens, you know, scope creep, is what we used to call it, for, of projects, and so, but it left us high and dry, so, you know, we could just work this into our operating budget, and it won't start until 2019, so it's the best of all possible ways.
Rather than having to scramble, which I thought was the case there for a little while.
Right.
They were willing to just push it a little further down the road, so we could build it in there, and not have this drug in our lap, so.
Yeah.
Yeah, you did well with that.
Okay, so, all right, so we'll let you know about that, but.
Okay.
All right, thank you.
Very good. Yeah, that's happening, let's see. Just as a sidebar to that, Dover's planning, I'm trying to flip their switch sometime around March 15th.
March 15th of this year, like 2 weeks or a week or whatever?
Yeah.
So what does that mean for us?
Basically, what we have to do now, and even means for Dover, I think they're still getting ahead of the curve on the 15th, because anybody that has a mutual aid agreement with the city of Dover has to have their radio frequencies changed and upgraded. And that includes about 27 communities. A two-way has to go to and reprogram all of their vehicles and portables and stuff to include their new frequencies and our new frequency. So it's a twofer. And there's no way that they're gonna be able to get that done by what's a week and Friday, I think, something like that.
It's close, yeah.
So I don't quite see it happen, but it's very close to getting done. Dover's gonna have all their stuff done. And the same thing with ours, because we used to piggyback with them on the same frequency. We've been pushed off to the left just a little bit, so we're basically gonna have our own now. So we're not walking on each other from time to time, but we're both doing the same incident. Or if they have storm-related incidents and we have storm-related incidents, we can, now we're gonna be on our own path. So that's still in the works, and that's some of the stuff that we're discussing with that MOU. Some of that still ties into even though it's a little further down the road, the town antenna and repeater and all that they want to put on the water tank, this is a sidebar. This is going to be the main one, but that'll be the sidebar too. But it'll all link together at the end.
Yeah, that's supposed to happen like June, I think.
Yeah, they got to dig a trench, and once the ground gets better, George can start doing what he's got to do. He's got to dig whatever they need to do to get up the hill, so I know they talked about it.
Oh, okay.
Just a matter of when they can get to it. Okay?
Yeah, that sounds good, thank you. Board member cities updates.
Any board meeting tomorrow?
I'm going to try to get to the fire engine demise on Wednesday.
I had a rec meeting last night.
They're going to do a more active kitchen.
Home Sunday, I don't know about it.
Take more than me, this is fine.
25th.
Me even go over there when they actually cut it up.
So how are things shaping up?
Wednesday.
Jody, wonderful. Our software is almost complete, just a few more glitches. They're going to be able to pay online and payment plan. The only thing you can't pay payment plans is the foreign healthcare for whatever reason. Or you can pay in paper still, but the online is quite nice. Most of the staff is coming back, and we already have some applications for the team adventure camp. Parents are already asking.
For employees, for counselors.
Yep, so one sent in her resume. Me and Brittany have to interview her this week.
How, when are you going to start? I mean, obviously, I'm always interested in the revenue side. So when, and the enthusiasm that, you know, the camps will engender, so when are you going to start registrations?
We're hoping to open them up by the 10th of this week, so the end of this week. We just have a few more online glitches that we want the parents to be able to say yes or no to. So that's a software thing that I have to deal with the software company tomorrow morning.
So it's going to be soon? You'll be opening it up by Saturday?
Okay, yeah, parents are already asking.
Oh, good, okay. Excellent, thank you.
Yeah.
Building permits?
First thing in the folder is an abatement meeting request from EverSource. They would like to meet with us regarding their assessment.
Of utility poles?
Got it.
They're questioning the assessment of utilities.
Well, it's, we should probably have Avatar.
Yeah.
Right, because unless y'all think you know how to manage this.
Ready for the next one?
Well, let's, yeah, hang on.
Corey, are you okay?
Yeah.
Well, the meeting would be with us and Avatar, I would say.
Yes, it includes Avatar.
Avatar can arrange for the meeting date, though. Fine, but, okay. As long as it's on a Monday evening.
As long as it's not.
I'm not taking time off for EverSource to get an abatement, I'm sorry. I'm not taking time off for that. They can come here on Monday evening.
All right, I didn't understand it. So a Monday evening is what you're suggesting?
Yeah, put it on there.
First building permit is 2018-012. It's 18 Wentworth Street. It's an electrical permit. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. The permit fee is $105. Next is building permit 2018-013, 14 Wentworth Street. Also electrical. Mr. Clark has reviewed it. It's $105 fee. That's it.
All going to read this for a minute here. Questions or comments on this? Is anyone ready to make a motion to accept this? This is a memorandum of agreement between the City of Dover and the Town of Rollinsford that would allow us to maintain analog communication equipment on the Dover Tower.
So moved.
Second.
Any questions or comments or anything else? All right, I'll call it. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Requires all of us to sign it as well.
I don't have any.
I'm just playing with it. The way I do with anything that comes into my grasp. It's like a child.
Okay. Move to accept purchase order 1383 to New Hampshire Department of Parks and Rec. This is for bus passes for summer camp. We're going to be purchasing 1 5-pass book and 1 10-pass book and an administration fee of $10. For a total of $360.
Second. Any discussion? So this is just out of the general recreation line, because we don't have it split out.
Well, it is divided out in the
in the detail spreadsheet.
Do you want the detail spreadsheet again? I can find it.
No, not right this very minute, but I think. What it would be helpful.
I know you wanted it spread out again next year.
Yes, for Caroline, we need to find a way, because obviously the rec, it's important that the rec committee can manage it the way that they understand it. It's important for Caroline to be able to know where to put all of these expenses when they come in. But the most important piece is that the taxpayers have, you know, some understanding of, under rec committee, you know, just, you know, supplies and transportation.
Yeah,
yeah, so that, but maybe not at the level of detail that the spreadsheet has, is all I'm trying to say. So maybe Caroline can work, can look at that spreadsheet and suggest somebody. And also, so it's, you know, and you know, when you're accounting, sometimes you want to look at it this way, sometimes you want to look at it that way. So sometimes you want to look at it by program, which for you might be, you know, by Camp Raleigh and then by the teen camp.
And it is.
Exactly. But for purposes of the town, we probably don't care to have it at that level of detail. So we would just combine the supplies of both. That's why I think, you know, if Caroline takes a look at this, she can maybe suggest something that's not onerous to her, that provides, I think, more detail than we're currently able to provide.
Okay.
So, at some point.
Sure. I'll send it to you. That's fine.
Yeah. All right. Any other comments or questions? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. That's going to be non-public.
Okay. And they were supposed to come in tonight. Caroline said they were coming. So that was last week.
Discuss it with us. Well, she's had to make some time.
Oh, this is the Hannaford?
Hannaford or something.
Oh.
They said they were coming. Or she said they were coming.
Okay, I didn't know that, but I don't see anybody.
If they show up,
okay.
We'll put it down here. All right, this is an offer letter to our new transfer station agent, effective April 27, 2016. What?
It's supposed to be a template that didn't get, what do you think?
The note says.
Oh, yeah, all right. So the date could change up above, but not here. So one of the things that Caroline did talk to me just briefly about this today, and that is that Mr. Kelsey, that is me, he thought we had posted this with a rate of $12 an hour.
I don't think it was posted with a rate.
And so, but it prompts the question, provokes the question of what is the offer? And so I suggested to Caroline, we're going to have to redo this anyway, so it's good. I said, I suggested to her, if she put 11 in, the board will talk about it. So the 11 is what, no one is getting paid less than 11.
Right.
Right, so that,
correct.
So is that,
yeah.
Okay, so I don't know what he, I don't know if she talked to him, she got back to him, but that's the rate we'll offer him. You good with that?
Yes, because he doesn't have any certification yet,
yeah.
So.
Okay, fine. So then, board, I'll ask Caroline to change this date, but otherwise, once she does that, I'll sign it.
Absolutely.
Good to me.
Okay, excellent, thank you.
Saying that Avatar was going to be sending
on the new property
that Kermit used didn't change.
Okay. Why did you want to say this?
He emailed it to me.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
I think
and this is a Nebraska bond bank. annual financial statement.
Oh, okay.
So
they just
looks like they just
want to.
Over our records.
All right, I will get in touch with them because we usually don't get the full financial statement until June. Can I have a post-it? What did they ask me to sign? Oh, they're just, they just want access. So I give the New Hampshire Municipal Bond Bank permission to request our annual financial statement directly from our auditor. Our financial statements are posted on our website and are available for download. Or please email me on an annual basis. So I'm going to say our financial statements are posted on our website. And I'll just say this one should be there around June.
Move to accept purchase order 1382 for Lavelle Computing Services for Town Hall. IT services of 10 hours for $760.
Second.
Any discussion? I actually have a comment. Caroline said that she would be putting in this purchase order, and it wasn't all that long ago before we did another one, And so I asked what was happening. I guess he did some work downstairs on the police.
Yes.
So that took a chunk of hours. And then he's been working on the virus stuff and the network and up here, so. All right, so I'll ready to call the questions. All those in favor say aye.
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 And this is our Northeast Regional Recovery Association, NRRA, which is our, people that help us with recycling and stuff, our annual membership, we paid our dues. I do want to give this to Russ and the transfer station guys, because they have classes and stuff that are happening in May.
Oh, good.
So that was great. He's been really taking the lead on that. Oh, I got a call from him today.
He?
From Russ. Well, text. They didn't come and pick up the cans when they were supposed to, so he called me to see if it was okay to call Shipyard. And I was on the slope, so I said, sure, go ahead. And I don't understand why he didn't go to George, so.
Yeah, he should have gone to.
I'll find out why, but, so. I said, yeah, you're not, yeah, that's fine.
So, but the bottom line is that Shipyard is going, or did go, or?
I'm assuming Shipyard showed up and took care of it there. You were good about coming in within hours. But I guess Lamprey didn't come, and I don't know why. I'm assuming it's because the gentleman is sick, and they were trying to find coverage for that anyway. But I thought Shipyard was covering them, so I'll find out the whole detail.
So, yeah, I'm just curious. We're still paying the Lamprey Regional Cooperative, however, we're not paying Shipyard directly. So our method of payment is still.
No, you pay Shipyard. If we call Shipyard directly, you pay Shipyard. But if we call.
But if it's the truck cooperative that's arranged to have Shipyard.
Right, because Paul's been sick.
Right.
Then that's different. But it sounds like they had some, from the text, it sounded like Lamprey was supposed to pick it up. And they didn't. So I'll find out more.
Okay.
I was on the middle of the slope, so.
Was it a good day?
It was, but it's hard to text and skate.
It is.
Yes. Don't recommend it. So, assessing services from another company. They're interested in our business. Received our tax exempt bond form. I'm going to let us know. I'm assuming that needs to be filed.
Mm-hmm. Looks like the two that we got from the municipal bond bank. So we can just file this.
About potholes on Oak Street. So, we got an email about
it. I couldn't help the something going on out there.
Oh, Chief!
Exactly. He's been sitting there very patiently.
I'm so sorry, Chief.
I've only been like 2 minutes. Feel free to do what you need to do. I'm in a hurry.
No,
we're
here late.
Pile.
All right.
I saw you. I said hello to you.
Yeah, it's just like we get space cadets here.
My other meeting ran longer than normally does. So I'm a little late.
Sorry, Chief.
Sorry. Yes.
Okay, the first item that I have is a Form B for the Police and Training Council. Officer Dronsfield has changed her last name from Dronsfield to Lito. So there's a form here that we have to let them know that she's done that. So we just need a signature date and title of the hiring authority on the bottom, please.
Okay. So, just sign right here, no objection board, I suspect, right?
Just presented the board with the latest copy of the emergency operations plan.
This is the one that just got...
That's the one we just completed, yes.
Thank you.
That's the select board's copy.
Where else are there copies? You have one clearly?
The fire station, police station, water and sewer, grade school, highway department, and town clerk. All the important places.
Town clerk and us, so...
Yes. So that's your copy. And you should have a copy in your office someplace.
It's usually in the boardroom, yeah.
And here we have a notice of promulgation, just indicating that these are the plans, they're going to be effective on today's date, if you'd like to sign that. There's a signature there for the chair and myself.
Let me read the notice of promulgation. So the publication of the Town of Rollinsford, New Hampshire Local Emergency Operations Plan, hereinafter referred to as the EOP, represents a concerted effort on the part of Rollinsford to provide a mechanism for effectively responding to and recovering from the impact of natural and human-caused disasters or emergencies. The purpose of this plan and associated supporting documents is to facilitate the delivery of local government, community, and mutual aid resources, and to provide needed assistance and relief to disaster victims in the community at large. The plan represents the community's best intentions to manage emergencies, disasters, and disasters within the framework of community-wide cooperation and coordination. So, does the board, can I have a motion then to say that we officially adopt the emergency operations plan? Okay. Any questions or comments? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. So we'll put today's date.
Sure.
Aye.
Yes.
Any other signatures of yours?
Just one more signature for the select board to sign for the...
All right, so now this is all of us, right? Oh, no, just
you,
me,
just
okay.
Chair.
So how is this different from that one?
This
it just
says
we
you're
get a
receiving
copy.
A copy.
Got it. Okay, so I'll sign this one.
Cut this off, please.
Next item. 2 weeks ago, we received a reimbursement from the state of New Hampshire Homeland Security for $3,671.18, and that was for half of the payment for the MDTs that we received last year. So the only thing that we have pending right now from 2017 is the $4,000 due to us for the EOP plan and the $25,000 for the repeater.
And the plans are still on board to put this in place, implement this in June, July time frame?
I think they were hoping to start at the end of this month, depending
okay.
on the weather.
Yeah. Excellent. And the receipt of the $25,000 is pending the deliverable, final report or something.
Correct.
We've installed
final report,
it.
Yeah. Everything been taken care of is installed and working properly.
Okay.
Yeah. And the last item that I have is the demo work at the old highway department has been finished.
Congratulations.
There is a nice empty lot up there right now.
That's great.
And I have had a couple of neighbors approach us and say, it looks good up there. Thank you for getting rid of the eyesore.
That's good work. Yeah, nice job.
I think that was the carrot in the box too.
I'll have to drive by, take a look myself.
That's all I have for you folks. Anything for me?
Yes, on 60 South Street. I'm not sure if it's for you or George, but there's furniture that's been left on the sidewalk. It's been there for about 2 weeks now. Blocking the sidewalk, some sort of giant dresser that's there.
I saw this one when he came to work.
Yeah. Yeah.
So it's in a public way, so maybe it is police.
I'll throw it.
You're the one who knocks on the door.
People that
live
there should take care.
Yes, right. We're not asking you to.
No, I know.
Trust me. Just asking you.
Actually, there was a dresser and two large trash cans, if I remember correctly. So
I think they got their garbage picked up, but they were full this morning. When I came home, they were blowing them like down the road. So I mean, their garbage got picked up.
Yeah, I was wondering if they were waiting for Best Way or Pennard or someone to come through
for
private trash
for a while,
to pick it up. I don't know.
Yeah.
But we'll check again tomorrow. We're still there tomorrow morning. We'll do some knock and talk.
All right. Thank
and
you.
See what else is going on.
Thank you.
All right. Anything else? All right, we're good. Thank you.
Tell me, don't forget to vote.
Of course.
All right. And voting, you're always here.
That's right, yes.
Thank you.
Have a good night.
Good night.
See you.
Good night, Bob.
All right. go back to the...
Back to potholes.
Oh, that's right, you were talking about potholes. So is this someone trying to put in a claim like Carolina's managed?
Yes, she emailed us about this resident last week.
So she's already contacted this person? Or is this a new one?
No, it's the same person. I don't know if she reached out to her as well. Because remember we were going to send it to Primax?
Yeah, she's been sending them all to Primax. I think there've been two or three. And so, I guess my question is, do we have to do anything or is Caroline just forwarded it?
No, I think Caroline already took care of it.
Okay, all right. Did you want to see this for any reason?
I'll email her just to make sure that she called Primax. And zoning board ordinance books still doesn't have a price. And I talked to Caroline earlier this week and she said, yeah, I forgot to put a price. And
purchase order needs a price.
Okay, still need a price. And that's it for the folder. Wait, I think, is that it for the folder? Yep, everything else is old.
All right, so we will be going to non-public to review legal guidance. So before, I'll just ask any community input. Yes, Charlie.
Yes, on the unregistered vehicles and other problems at 112 Rollins Road, is there any update on that?
There is no update. We're in the process of trying to, Tom just got back from a two-week vacation. It's been illegal. So we need to figure out where, you know, we've been using legal for other things, and other people have, you know, we've got right to knows, we've got other issues, and so legal time has been taken up by other things. So and we had all of the bond work last year, so I think it sort of fell by the wayside. So Caroline, when I checked, Caroline found last. Tom's response said that he believed it's with legal, so we need to follow up with legal. All right. I'll look for a motion to go into
non-public session.
I'll do a roll call. Michael?
Yes.
Jody? Suzanne? Yes. So, Corey, don't hang around.
Yeah.